right? Swinging on a branch, right? So kind of like Tarzan the Monkey Man, swinging from a rubber band. He slips, he falls, he breaks his mighty. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Jeff Koga here, and I'm actually leaving the office right now. Surprise, surprise, I had a rough week, but I woke up in the middle of the night. I kid you not, like, my stomach was rumbling. I couldn't sleep, and I went to the office, and I got in about a little before 4:30 a.m., and I'm leaving right now, which is a little past 11, so I got a good solid, like, 5-6 hours of work in, and I got a lot of stuff done. Oh, my God. Gosh, I got a lot of stuff done, and it feels good. It feels good when you're executing. It's gonna come into what I want to talk about. So in this episode, I want to talk about a Japanese proverb called "Even a monkey falls from a tree." This proverb was told by my dad. I remember him saying, because he used to say all these like liners, right? These one-liners, and and in Japanese, it means Saru mo kikara ochiru. Saru mo kikara ochiru. Now, what that really means, translate into, is even a monkey will fall from a tree, right? And what that means to me, and what I think it should probably mean to you, because it feels weird. I mean, I'm sure it sounds and feels weird, which is, hey, you know, a monkey is supposed to be really good at climbing trees, hence they're monkeys. They swing, right? Swinging on a branch, right? So kind of like Tarzan the Monkey Man, swinging from a rubber band. He slips, he falls, he breaks his mighty. Actually, that was the thing that we used to do, right, as kids. But again, a monkey is gonna slip and fall. And literally, I think this week that's what it was, because again, I wasn't able to execute some of the stuff I needed to this week, and I think this quarter is a crucial time in the business in terms of growth, because one, we're launching multiple products; two, we're putting a lot of new automation into the business, as well as the team members are really skilling up. You know, like my assistant Mary, she's learning how to use some new tools. She started even doing some like chopping up videos. I'm bringing back my old video guy Jonathan as well. That's gonna do a lot of the new stuff for me and be able to blow some of the stuff up. My wife Elaine, who's been helping me a lot, has been, you know, really, really, you know, doing a lot, you know. And sometimes I keep on forgetting, and I know she watches this, so this is for you, babe, is that sometimes I'm really, really tough on you, so I'm sorry. Yeah, and I should not do that, which is to use you maybe as a punching bag. And if you're watching this, I'm sorry, I love you, and things like that. So, because really, for her, it's been a year only, right? Really doing this entrepreneurial journey or whatever. And I've been doing it for a long time. I've been through, you know, literally hell and back, you know, doing this stuff. So my ability to, my bag that can carry a lot of is pretty damn big. And it dawned on me a couple weeks ago when she said, yeah, it's been like a year since I really, you know, started helping you out with this. And I was like, really? And then I was like, damn, she has come a long way, man. And really, really happy that she has, you know, because I'm a firm believer, you know, marriage is about a partnership. You know, I know sometimes people say, hey, you know what, I don't want my wife doing, you know, business with me, or I don't want to be involved in doing business with family and stuff. I think you should. You know, you're building a legacy, right? Any family that I know that have started and built something, right? They build it so that way they can pass it on to the next generation, next generation, next generation, and that's what I'm currently doing, right? So, a lot of my friends that are in kind of like the same boat, right? Same age, we're like the millennial age. We're not your typical millennial for anyone that's watching, right? The one that the older people think that, hey, we're entitled. The older people think that, hey, we don't work hard. The older people think that, hey, we're lazy, right? Like, we don't work hard, we're lazy, we're entitled. Everything was given to me. And this trophy attitude of, hey, given a trophy and everything won is the reason why we're failing. No, okay? I don't believe that. A lot of my friends, you know, especially the second generation group, right? I'm talking about, hey, their parents are immigrants and we were born here, right? We still got the roots of just working hard, like just like pit bulls, you know? As a matter of fact, I just talked to my brother just right now, and we're just having a conversation about that, you know? And we're about to go see my dad celebrate his birthday. It was on the 26th, and, you know, and it reminds me that I got to go thank him again for some of the stuff that he taught me. Because growing up, because my parents divorced at an early age, I blamed them on a lot of stuff. I really did. I really did, yeah. My brother stayed with my dad, and I went with my mom, and I blamed him for a lot of stuff. And reality was just a direct reflection of who I was. And as I've gotten older, I've come to peace at it, as well as I've reestablished a relationship, as well as, and that has to do a lot with my wife helping me out. And a lot of the baggage I was carrying, I finally let go of that. And I was telling my brother about how this Japanese saying, this proverb, "Asaru mo kikara ochiru," he used to say that. And it's dawning on me, is one of the reasons why I can get back up. And me and my brother were just laughing about how I remember when we were really young, you know, I think we may have been like 5 or 6 or something like that. My dad would actually make us put like gloves on, like I'm talking about like these junior gloves, right? And we would box each other. Okay, and keep in mind, me and my brother, we're only a little bit like a little over a year apart. Okay, so but when you're that age, right? I think, I don't know exactly how old we were, maybe 6 or 7 or something like that, right? The year difference makes a world of a difference in time, in terms of strength, man. And I told him that, and I was telling my brother that, I was like, yeah, remember that time? He's like, yeah, man. Remember you would punch me in my face and my nose would start bleeding. And dad would get Kleenex and stuff it in my nose, and they would go like round 2, and then you'd punch me in the same spot again, and the tissue paper will come out and my nose will start bleeding again, and I'm crying and tears coming out my eye, snot's coming out, blood's coming out my nose, and my dad would be like, fight, learn to fight, keep your hands up, protect yourself, you know. And my brother laughed, and he's like, man, those were good times, you know. I bet it was for him, you know. So but you know, we did that around the block with a bunch of the different kids in the neighborhood too, you know. We, you know, as we got older, we put gloves on and literally we would fight, and we would do like 1 minute or 60 second rounds, and we would box each other, you know. It was one of those things that we just did as kids, you know. I don't know if kids these days do that or not, like put boxing gloves on and fight, but we would do that, and we would get in fights, you know. And I think really that being able to take that slug and really, you know, because I'm telling you, man, when you get your nose busted, it's a totally different feeling, right? Like everything, you know, gets thrown out the window. So as kids, learning that has really helped, and really that concept of you know, hey, a monkey will even fall from a tree is so true, you know. And today was redemption. Even though I wish I was in the zone and I'm feeling good and I was getting a lot of stuff done, I'm gonna go see my dad and tell him about that story. I think, you know, I think he'll probably laugh, and I'll have to make sure that I tell him and I thank him for at least telling me and actually raising me in the right way, I think, or what I think it is. Because again, growing up, you know, especially my teenage years and going through my high school years, I really resented him for a lot of stuff. Because I saw the struggle that my mom was going through, and I blamed literally him for it. And you know, and he's a good man, you know. It's just things in life happen. And on my 21st birthday, I remember we went to go drink. That was kind of like the first time we actually drank together. And we were in Little Tokyo. We were at a place called Shinsengumi, I believe, yeah. And we were drinking, and he was kind of drunk. I was a little tipsy, right? And he told me, you know, he was just like, yeah, I was an idiot. I don't know if I told you this, but I was an idiot. You know, your mom's such a good person, and I just, you know. And he even said, hey, if I could turn back the clock, I would have done things differently. But I'm so proud that, you know, hey, you and Chris, you know, came out okay, because I worried about that as you guys were getting older, you know. And it's one of those things where, like in the Japanese culture, right? I don't know if this is just an Asian thing. Maybe other culture happens, right? You don't really have that heart-to-heart talk with your dad. You know, I know. Daughters probably will have a lot more heart-to-heart with their like moms and stuff like that. But for me, that was the first time actually having that. It felt really good. And And sometimes I forget that, you know, it was a reminder today, obviously, of being, we're going to go celebrate my dad's birthday, that I'm going to go and say, hey, thank you. Thank you for what you taught me. Thank you for what you give. So for anyone else out there, you know, if you haven't seen your dad, you're a younger person or something like that, and you have some issues with it, you know, hey, I'm telling you, and I'm sure I feel like it's the older uncle or the older cousin or something like that. I feel like it's preaching or something like that. But really, you know, go make that peace, right? Because you never know when they're going to be gone. And it's really, for me, it's living in the gratitude moment really came to play with what I kind of realized. I was just like, yeah, my wife's grandpa, it was his, I guess, death anniversary, I guess. Yeah, is that what you call it? Yeah, so it's been 1 year since he passed away. And I was like, wow, it flew by really fast. And most individuals aren't going to live past the centurion mark, right? Most people aren't going to get past maybe 100. Maybe with technology and things like that, right? Maybe you will, right? I heard of a new thing where you can take young people's blood and actually put it in your body, right? And use it as yours, and supposedly you get more energy and you can perform. And I was told that CEOs are actually doing that now. So that way they can actually get a lot more stuff done and have a lot more energy. And I was like, wow. You know, so that was really interesting, kind of like really like hacking your body for peak performance. I was like, whoa, you know. So, but the point of this recording is, one is, hey, whatever it is, doesn't even matter if you're running a business, or, you know, hey, maybe you've been trying to get your business off the ground, or maybe you're working, and or maybe you don't even have a job and you're searching for a job, right? Just know, hey, a monkey is gonna fall from a tree. You know, a sarum will kick out a kikara ochiru, right? Meaning, a monkey's gonna fall from a tree, and you just gotta get back up and get climbing, you know. And it boils down to finding, also, in my opinion, what that big why is, right? Find that big why, and you'll find a way to keep going. I'm telling you, you'll find a way to keep going. When things are getting tough, you know, and really find the stuff that really excites you, you know. I know some of the stuff, if you're doing your job, right, and if you're doing running business, some stuff, sometimes when you're doing like the startup phase, you know, obviously I'm no longer in the startup phase of my business, because, you know, I've been doing it for a long time, but I'm trying to scale now to another level. But if you're in the startup phase and you just started, you've been doing it only for a couple years or something like that, and you run into those challenges, just know everyone goes through it, and just think of the why. And it's amazing, you know. So that's kind of my Saturday message for anyone out there in the internet land that's watching this. And so leave a comment below. Let me know what are some challenges that you faced before where you felt like the monkey, and the monkey fell from the tree, but you got back up. Let me know in the comment box, because I got tons and tons of those, a story myself personally, that has happened. And and that's all I got for you. So this is Jeff Koga. Just know, it's never game over until you die. That's all I got. Love y'all. Thanks for watching. Take care and bye-bye.